Hey, happy Sunday. I'm Chelsea from thestudentarchitect.com, where I create software tutorials and provide a variety of resources for architects and architecture students. If you want to learn how to build better models faster, consider checking out my Foundations of Revit course over at thestudentarchitect.com/classes. So today we're going to talk about how to hide patterns in Revit. So this applies to roof patterns, floor patterns, wall patterns, any type of pattern that you might have. These methods will apply to any type of component that you might have in Revit. So as with most things in Revit, there are a few different ways that you can go about doing this. Let's say for this example, we want to hide the roof patterns. One way that I could do this is click on one of these roofs here and right click on my mouse, go to Override Graphics and View. And let's say maybe I just want to hide the roof pattern for this individual roof, but I want to keep them for all of the other roofs in this view. I'm going to click on By Element to do that. And you'll see Surface Patterns here, and I could just uncheck Visible, hit Apply, and then you'll see it go away, and you'll see that all of the other roof patterns are still there. If I cancel that, and then go back into that again, right click on my mouse, Override Graphics and View, you can see that I can also do it by category. So if I uncheck visible here, hit apply, you'll see that that applies to all of the roofs that are in this view. So this time I'm going to hit okay, and now I'm going to click VG on my keyboard. I'm going to go down to roofs by hitting R on the keyboard. And you can see under the visibility graphic overrides panel, under the surface patterns, you can see it's set to hidden. So when you make a change using the right click option, override graphics by category, that sets a global setting for the entire view. So if I make it visible, hit okay, you'll see them come back. So if I do it by elements, override graphics and view by elements, uncheck visible, hit apply, hit okay, then go back into visibility graphics by hitting VG on the keyboard, going down to roof, you'll see that there's no setting here. There's no override because it's only that one individual roof that has that setting applied to it. Now, the last way that we can do this is by using view templates. And I highly recommend using view templates for as many views as you can within your project because it just makes it so much simpler and faster to control the graphics of your views on a more global scale. So if we go over to the properties panel, I'll go down to identity data and then you'll see view template. So where it says none, I'll just click on that. And then we'll apply the floor plan template here. Model overrides. We'll go down to roof. Uncheck visible. Hit OK and hit apply. And again, it will do the same thing, but the difference here is that change, that setting will apply to any view in this project that has that template applied to it. So if I hit OK again, you'll see that if I hop over to another view here, I'll go to the roof plan, you'll see that the roof plan also has the floor plan template applied to that view, and you'll see that the roof pattern is gone from there as well. So if I double click and try to change the setting now, go to override graphics, you'll see the category is grayed out, and that's because a view template is applied to the view and that it needs to be, that setting needs to be controlled within the view template dialog box. I can still override by element, but I can't override by category when there is a view template applied to the view. So if I go back into the view templates, turn it back on by going to model overrides, again, hit R on the keyboard to jump down to roof, make it visible, hit OK, OK again, OK for a third time, and then go back to floor plans, you'll see that those hatch patterns are back on in both of those views. One last way that you can do this is you could just edit the material itself. So if I double click to activate the view and then click on one of the roofs here, I can go to edit type, structure, and then I can just turn off this pattern here, just say none, hit okay again, and hit okay a couple more times, and then you'll see that applied to any roof that has that same roof type applied to it. So I really hope that you found this video helpful. And if you did, please hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. It really helps out my channel and it lets YouTube know that you like videos like this and they'll show you more of them. I really hope you have a great day and I'll see you next Sunday.